يا بسم الله هو رسالة الحديث today إن شاء الله.
أنا.
وردت.
أنا.
إن شاء الله. توكل الله.
عن أم المؤمنين أم عبد الله عائشة رضي الله عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من حدث في أمرنا هذا من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد.
رواه البخاري ومسلم.
ومسلم من عمل عملا ليس عليه أمرنا فهو رد.
You see, number one, عن أم المؤمنين. Who is أم المؤمنين؟
عائشة رضي الله عنها.
Yeah, why we call her أم المؤمنين? Why call the mother of the believers?
She's a scholar.
Why you call her? Why we should call عائشة أم المؤمنين? Allah said that in the Quran. Allah said, وَأَزْوَاجُهُ أُمَّهَاتُهُمْ. I think it's Surah An-Nur. Allah said, and the wives of Prophet ﷺ, the mother of the believers. Allah said that in the Quran, Kareem. So all the wives of Prophet ﷺ, our mother. Okay. عن أم المؤمنين, أمي عبد الله. She has no kids, but she called أمي عبد الله, as I told you in the Arabic culture. They call the male and female by the nickname Abu Fulan, like me, Abu Muhammad. And another one, Abu Hussein, Abu Ali, Abu Khalid, Abu Ja'far, okay? Abu Bakr, Abu Hafs, Abu Abdullah, Abu Abdurrahman. Okay, here, Umm al-Mu'mineen, his nickname, even though she hadn't any kids, any baby. And Umm Abdullah, Aisha, radiyallahu anha. Aisha, you know Aisha. Aisha, the wife of Prophet Sallam, she's only Prophet Sallam married her like a virgin. All of them, other women, like a widow. Only Aisha was a virgin. Radiallahu anha. Qala, she said, Qala Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Prophet Muhammad said, this now we talk about what? What the first part of the hadith called?
The Sanad.
The Sanad. Yeah. من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. All in all, I said, who bring anything new to our religion, فهو رد. That means rejected, completely rejected. Whoever brings something new to our religion, we don't accept it. Because Allah said in the Quran Kareem, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم. What Allah said? That's what he needs here. Here only, in this hadith, we need only this. اليوم أكملت لكم
دينكم.
دينكم, that means the laws of the Islam. The ahkam, what halal, what haram. If someone bring another thing, we don't accept it. We complete, yeah. Alhamdulillah. Okay, when you need to put something in you, we have to reject something from this completed thing. Okay? When you want to put something bid'ah, we have to push to brush out a sunnah. We have to brush out a sunnah to use a bid'ah. Because of that, now people of the bid'ah, they hate the sunnah, or they don't like the sunnah, because the sunnah actually defeated them. They only need their desires. They put something new and they push or brush out the sunnah from the shelf. For example, when you have shelf and you have, for example, 10 books in this shelves, this is the Islam. When you want to put a new book, not a bid'ah, you have to push a book from the shelf. Because there is no space. It's full for 10 books. Do you understand this point?
Yeah.
Yes. This hadith was mentioned, was reported by Bukhari Muslim. And there is another hadith only mentioned by Muslim. Man amila amalan. who do anything, عمل عاملا. ليس عليه أمرنا. That means is not complaining. Is not complying with our order is rejected as well. We don't accept it. The same hadith, the same meaning, but this riwayah of the Bukhari and this riwayah of Muslim. Man ahdatha, here man amila. But the point is different between them. Man ahdatha, that means maybe someone say something new in the Islam, but he doesn't work it. That in the first hadith, only ahdatha, only bring it to Islam. But the second riwayah say man amila, and
whoever does,
man who practice, who perform that. The number one mentioned man ahdatha, just to bring. Maybe someone say, I don't do that, but I believe, for example, the birthday celebration of Rasulullah, that a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
For example, okay, and he never do that, but he said I believe that is right. That means ahdatha, but who practice man amila.
Amila.
You know that what different mean in practice man ahdatha and man amila.
Yes.
Ahdatha just to bring to Islam something new, but amila that means to practice. You can stop now. You can stop sharing the screen. Jazakallahu khair, Fawaz. So. I think we reached to end, I think. Are you happy?
I'm happy.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Any question?
You see the way we do sometimes hadith, we do hadith. Can we have like certain days where we just learn like stories of Sahaba as well? And maybe...
Whenever you want, just let me know. All my time, Alhamdulillah, free now, especially now in the lockdown time. Okay, give me whatever you want. I give you every time a story about the Sahaba. But look to me, brother, to be honest with you, let me stop recording and come to you, inshallah.